Welcome to everyone who's joined us today in our webinar, Discover 8 Ways to Easily Maximize Member Signups on Your Membership or Directory Website. Today's presenters is, my name is Jason Halusum. I am the co-founder of Brilliant Directories. We started Brilliant Directories back in 2009, and we used it first to create our own directory websites. And from there, we realized that there's tons of use for other people to use this software. And here we are today with thousands and thousands of users powering so many websites around the internet. And we're glad that all of you have joined us today.
And my name is David Rockland. I'm the digital strategist here at Brilliant Directories. I've been here in different roles for a few years. I was able to start off as an intern, and I'm taking on the role as digital strategist.
And a quick note, we'd love for you to join us in our Brilliant Directories LinkedIn group. It's focused on online marketing strategies, and it gives us an opportunity to interact with all of you. So you can just head to this link here, and if you're logged into LinkedIn, just request to join the group, and we'll add you right away. Also, we're giving $100 off of our Kickstart onboarding package to help you make some of the adjustments that you'll see here in this webinar. This is open to the first 100 people that purchase this package, so check out brilliantdirectories.com/webinar1, and if the discount is still live on the bottom of that page, then feel free to take advantage of it. Also on that page will be lots of takeaway material for you, such as a free worksheet, some free reading materials, as well as a free copy of this webinar, so you can listen to it, watch it, whenever you have some spare time.
All right. And before we get this webinar kicked off, we'd like to start with a poll. We have a lot of guests with us today. And you'll notice on your screen, we just want to know how many of you in the audience are a current Brilliant Directories, a customer, user, partner, if you currently have a website with Brilliant Directories. If you could just answer yes or no, that'll give us an indication about where everyone is with this webinar. Perfect. So we have about 75% of the people in the webinar, 76, are Brilliant Directories users, and about 24% are new, probably considering Brilliant Directories. So we hope that this webinar provides you with some good information about the type of decisions to make when you're starting your membership community or directory website. All right, so today's topic is, just to reiterate, discover 8 simple ways to maximize member signups on your directory websites. These tips and strategies are really good for websites that are just starting out. It's good for established organizations who kind of want to take another look at their strategy for getting membership signups. But I'm a big advocate for these strategies and utilizing them when you're first starting your membership or directory website. So these are foundational steps and things to look at to make sure you're on the right track to success with your directory website.
So the goal of this webinar is to help all of you increase your member signups. We'll be giving you 8 tips showing you how you can do this. And none of them are really all that complicated. Our goal here is to save you a bunch of time and effort while still being able to meet your goals. And we're going to be able to build these memberships by building stronger relationships with our members as well as with our website's visitors.
That's right. The topics that we'll cover today are how to maximize member signups, what compels members to join your site. So kind of getting into the mental head of what a member wants to see, what's going to emotionally compel them to want to join your site. And then most important, in my opinion, are things to avoid and things not to do for your directory website. And the strategies that we're going to talk about today relate and apply to anyone who manages any type of membership community or network and wants to maximize their member signups. So as I said before, these are just good fundamental best practices. Some of the tips may apply or may not apply in your industry, but it's good to take note of them and make sure that you are on the right track to success for your membership community.
And to add to that also, keep these tips in mind throughout the lifespan of your website. These aren't just good to implement while you're redesigning your site or while you're launching your site. It's good to keep these in mind, so at any point in time, you may find that you can implement one of these tips that we share with you. So the industries that these tips will work in is any industry, any membership community, any directory-based website, especially when you are starting out, but these will work throughout the lifespan of your website. Now, just a quick heads up, these tactics that you see on your screen right now are not the only way to get more members. Word of mouth referrals, spam email marketing, expensive online advertising, which a lot of people fall into the trap of, developing every feature you can think of for your website is not necessary, and waiting for correct, best in the industry search engine optimization. These are things that while they may help you gain more members, they aren't the most important things, and they're not going to help you gain the ideal members that you want for your website.
Yeah, I just want to touch on a couple of these notes here. Think of your membership website, especially while you're starting out, as a phase one and a phase two and phase three, a plan of action. Your phase one should be to get the most basic fundamental aspects of your directory to a marketable stage where you can get members to sign up. They understand the concept of your website. And what I see a lot is in the beginning stages, everyone is very excited to get their website online. They have lots of ideas of how they want their website to work. They're comparing their website to competitors that they want to emulate. And it can become very easy to start wanting to overdevelop your website. So the number four point here, developing every feature you can think of, you might want to hold off on certain things until you're out of the phase one stage of your membership website, which is getting it to a baseline marketable stage.
Now, if you thought these were the only ways to gain more members, it's totally not your fault. We completely understand and we empathize with you. Managing websites is not something that we're taught how to do. It's not something we inherently know how to do. And most of us haven't studied at any point web design or marketing. We're kind of rolling with the punches and learning on the go as we go ahead with our website.
That's a really good point. And a lot of people starting out, especially if you're a sole proprietor, you're wearing many hats in your organization. You're obviously the business owner, you're the accountant, you're the marketer, you're probably managing a small or medium-sized staff. So, not knowing exactly what to do, there's nothing to be ashamed of, because the whole point of you being in this webinar and even us having this webinar and hearing your feedback at the end, everyone is here to learn and have a good constructive experience. So just know that there's always more to learn, and don't be down on yourself if you've tried your directory website and you haven't gotten the results you've wanted yet, because tomorrow is a new day and you can learn new things today.
So the good news is that you can convert more website visitors into member signups without spending a fortune on mega marketing, on really expensive online advertising, expensive marketing tactics. None of that is needed to be a great marketer and to market your website and your service, your business, extremely well.
So here, there's one catch with wanting to have a successful membership directory and maximizing signups. You actually need to have a service that people want. You need to be able to clearly define what that service is and why it's beneficial. If people come to your website and there's ambiguous text around your website that is not clear about who your audience is or what the person should be doing on your website, people will be lost and people will not want to engage your website. They'll probably leave. So as simple as this sounds, it's just very important to have a clear message on your website, and that's going to help you get more member signups.
Yeah, the key to that is really being able to understand what it is your members need and what it is they want, and then being able to address those needs and wants.
Right.
But none of this will matter if you don't have a clear and focused website. That's really the major key here. So there's two types of websites. We have unclear and confusing websites, which oftentimes have confusing call to actions and no clear purpose and benefits. Now, a call to action is essentially a button on your website or a text box on your website that tells the visitor what to do, whether that be to register, to sign up for your newsletter, to buy a membership package. That's what a call to action is. And then on the opposite side, we have clear and focused websites. These are the ones that attract the most members. They have focused call to actions, and they have clear purpose and benefits communicated right there on their homepage and really throughout their entire website. So what this ultimately boils down to is just one simple thing.
Just one thing.
Building relationships. That's the ultimate takeaway here. And the key to gaining more members is you have to be able to build strong relationships.
So David, let me ask you a question. What does it mean to build relationships? How can a website build a relationship with people?
Well, you can build relationships through building trust, credibility, loyalty, reliability, commitment, and sincerity. Ultimately, the way you can think of this is to really make your website embody what you think the ideal friend would be. The ideal friend would be trustworthy. They'd have a lot of credibility. They'd be loyal, reliable, committed to your friendship, and at all times they'd be sincere. So really try to communicate all of those characteristics through your website. And we will show you how to connect with prospective members on all of these points throughout this webinar.
So here's something important to note is also what we're not going to learn today. We're not going to teach you how to spam market to people to join your website, sending 100,000 emails to people, hoping that they'll join. We're not going to teach you how to trick people into signing up to your website. And we're also not going to teach you complicated website development for bells and whistle features you need on your site, because that's not going to result in more member signups. And the last thing is, which I'm very adamant about, is we're not going to teach you how to overwork yourself with mundane and tedious tasks. We're going to show you simple, quality, proven ways that you can implement today to help you get more members to sign up to your website.
Now, what we will be teaching you today is how to clearly define your service or whatever it is your website may be offering. We'll show you how to simplify and what you can do to simplify your membership structure. By that, we mean making sure you don't have 10 different membership plans, packages that visitors can choose from. We want to keep that real simple, not give them too many options. We'll also show you how you can make your service more appealing. And that's done largely through the communication that you do through your website. And we'll also show you how you can gain exposure from industry icons. This is really important because we'll teach you how you can reach out to others in your industry who already have credible followings and use their followers, their members, to kind of kickstart your website or your member base. So today's outline is, first things first, we're going to be going through the 8 keys to maximize member signups. Then we're going to be going over the fundamental do's and don'ts. These are things you want to steer clear from. And lastly, we'll follow up the webinar with a question and answer session where you guys can ask us your own questions and we'll do our best to answer them and address your concerns.
All right. Before we dive into that, let's do another poll. And this is more geared towards people who are just starting their website. If you can answer the question there, how long should it take you to set up your membership community? And we're talking about getting a phase one marketable website online where you can start getting members to join your site. So it looks like 7% of people said 1 to 5 hours, 28% said 2 to 3 days, 47%, which is the most, said 1 to 2 weeks, and 19% said more than a month. All right, thank you for that. Now, in some industries, it might differ, and there really is no right answer. I think the right answer is, if you follow the steps in this webinar, if you can get your site online as quickly as possible so you're not wasting your own time, your own money, and going down the path of searching for perfection, because there is no such thing as a perfect website. Your website will always evolve. You should try to get your website online as quickly as possible with the minimal that you need. And a lot of people think, well, you only get one shot to make an impact on people. And if your website isn't perfect, then they're never going to come back to your website. Well, the fact of the matter is, if you start with a simple offering and you have less moving parts on your website, there's less things that can go wrong on your membership website. And you can grow your offering and you can grow features of your website over time. Because like we said, your website will evolve with more features, more awesomeness, but you want to start with the basics. So let's dive right into it.